flawlessly executed. Bravo.
What did you expect from world's most dangerous frog and number one criminal number two?
Yeah, I know. You're number one, I'm number two. I think you mentioned that before.
Now that we control the Muppet Tour number two, phase one of our plan is complete. We are now positioned to carry out greatest burglary. Yes.
In Muppets Most Wanted, the Muppets find themselves wrapped into a European jewel heist caper headed by a Kermit the Frog lookalike and his dastardly sidekick. I'm Jared Kingery along with Kiko Martinez from Cinesnob.net. I had a hard time saying that for some reason. What did you think of Muppets Most Wanted?
You know, first I have to apologize for the last Muppets movie. I think I was a little harsh on it. I gave it a
C+.
I saw it a couple of more times. B minus, B.
Oh,
so somewhere around
Muppets
there.
Muppets softened your hard heart.
They did. Well, the music in the first one was great, and the same thing here. There's some really great songs that, you know, I was just like, remembering like four or five
by Brett McKenzie
who won the Oscar last year for Man or Muppet, which is just a great song in itself. Same thing here. I liked it about as much as I did the first one. The story itself, I mean, it's a case of a mistaken identity. It doesn't really get too...
It's very reminiscent of the Great Muppet Caper, if you're familiar with that.
Definitely. And here we get some good cameos by a lot of celebrities. The funniest ones coming from Danny Trejo. And... the other prisoners
Ray Liotta, Hornswoggle from the WWE, if you remember that. I gotta say, I didn't feel as fond of this Muppet movie as I did the last one. The last one was kind of a big nostalgia trip. This one felt, I want to say, a little more TV movie-ish, maybe?
Well, when you don't have somebody, some of the same people that you did in the first one.
You don't have Jason Segel, you don't have Amy Adams.
Right. It kind of doesn't feel the same. It is a different movie, I mean, but in terms of Muppet comedy and things like that, you don't miss out.
I still laughed, I still enjoyed the songs, I just didn't quite feel the love for it that I felt for the first movie.
I think you're just waiting a little too long for that first movie to come.
probably, because the Muppets had been mistreated long before this.
Right.
Oh, I don't want to get into it right now. It does feel a little cheaper, maybe, like Disney kind of cheaped out. Like, the last sequence has one of the worst special effects I've ever seen in a theater in a big budget movie, right?
You are right.
We won't spoil it, but anyway. Right. All right, what's your grade for this?
I'll give this a B-.
A B-, that is right on target with the critical average of a B-. All right, remember, before you head out to the theater this weekend, be sure to check out the rest of our reviews on Cinesnob.net.